Hi, I'm Donovan with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Steve to talk about Azure Container Registry. Welcome to the show, Steve.
Thanks, Donovan. Good to be here.
So what do you do here at Microsoft?
So I'm a program manager. I work on our container registry among some other Docker tooling related scenarios with Visual Studio and some other things.
Cool. So tell me what's new with Azure Container Registry.
Yeah, so one of the things that we've been seeing is as customers are starting to use registries and container deployments more and more, they're starting to take advantage of Azure's global footprint.
Okay.
Where they have multiple locations they want to serve content from. So I could got a little slides here to kind of set that up. We use our proverbial Contoso here,
sure.
Where they're running some data centers in Canada, as well as two locations in the US and even Europe. And you know, they might want to have a separate registry in Europe, because with registries, we always want them to be close to our deployments. Images can get big. There's a nice layering system that I can pull deltas. But as soon as you have a new node, you know, a new VM that's hosting Docker containers, it has to pull all of those base images as well. So
correct.
That takes some time. And as soon as it's far away, it's longer, because it takes longer to get there. Because it's outside of the data center, you have network fragilities.
Sure.
And you're paying network egress fees.
Gotcha.
So we really want a container registry close. So here, what I'll show is the development teams in West US. Now they're maintaining two registries. And they've got to push twice
right.
in this case. And even though they're pushing twice, they still have to pull from two different registries. In fact, here in the US and in Canada, they're pulling from one registry. So whereas West Europe, that's local, that's great. But I have this nice network closeness here, but I still have these problems. So I kind of have a little bit of goodness and a little bit of badness in both. And that's the pain point that we wanted to take away.
And if you were to continue this, it would become more painful, because I'd have to push multiple times to multiple registries.
Exactly.
Okay.
So what we're doing now is we'll say is go to the container registry, click on the map, add these other locations. You now push to one and only one registry. We will replicate through ACR to those different locations.
Okay.
So now your local deployments, in fact, we'll raise webhooks so that you can raise a notification. And then every one of those nodes that are in each one of those regions can do a local pull.
So if I had already set this up, let's say you know I'm a DevOps guy. So I've already mm-hmm. set this up in Visual Studio Team Services. I have it building my image, and I have it pushing to a registry. To take advantage of this, I wouldn't have to change my build at all.
No.
I would just have to go and tell ACR, I now need you to replicate this for me. My DevOps pipeline stays the same, but now I have the power of all this geo-replication.
Exactly. You're going to push once, and then we will deploy it across whatever regions you told us to deploy it to.
One other question.
Sorry, replicate the images, not deploy, right?
Got
deploy
it.
Is
exactly.
a separate thing.
Exactly. Okay, that was my next question. How does each of my hosts now know that they're pulling from a different registry?
So that's the beauty of what we're doing with ACR, is you're still pulling from one registry. We use Traffic Manager. And we just do the the closest deployment model.
Awesome.
So the fact that you're in West Europe, inside that data center, the traffic manager routing says, well, I got an endpoint right here. I'm going to give you that one.
Perfect. So I don't
as well as developers right there. It's right. If their developer is off in West Europe somewhere sitting at his desk, we can serve them there locally as well.
Perfect. So the commands I even issue to my host to run my images doesn't change.
Nope.
It figures that stuff out for me.
Yep.
Awesome.
So let's do a demo
sure.
of how this works. We'll come over here to the portal, and here what I'm going to do is create a new registry. So we'll just call this ACR AZ Friday, and we'll come over here. So that's the name of my registry.
Okay.
Put it in a resource group, and I'm going to put it in West US here to start. And we'll just keep it as the standard SKU here, and we'll talk about that in a moment.
Okay.
So we have three SKUs, basic, standard, and premium. Basic being that entry point for the quick proof of concept, really cost effective. Standard, we expect the majority of developers would use, and premium being a more high volume and
so where we'll do geo-replications. So is the service you're about to show us available in all three SKUs, or just standard and above?
All three. Well, geo-replication is a feature of premium, and that's exactly what we'll go into here in a second.
Okay.
But let's go through the basics here. So here's our registry. It was created really quickly because mm-hmm. it's managed. There's no additional resources to provision. And if we look at the repositories, we of course don't have any because we just created this registry. So we'll come over here, and I've got a set of images. I have this ACR Hello World. So I'm going to say Docker. Well, actually, I'll do a Docker tag first. ACR Hello World. And to push an image to a private registry, you just give it the registry URL, acrazf.azurecr.io. /acr/hello-world. So now I've got an image that's tagged that. Before I could push to that private registry, I need to get authenticated.
Sure.
And this is another feature that we've simplified. So now I could do az acr login. And what this will do, and I'll just say dash n for the registry name. And what this will do is it's going to take my az login token for my Azure identity and just apply it to, it helps if I spell it right.
Always.
You know, computers should just autocorrect.
They should know what you want to do and just do it for you.
That's what I think.
That's what AI is all about.
Okay.
It's coming.
So now I'll take my tag command and I'll just convert it to a push.
But I want to talk about something else that just happened while this is pushing.
Yeah.
I've logged in the AZ, and I don't have to log in explicitly to my ACR. I can just tell it, hey, use what I logged in already as and authenticate against my
When you say AZ ACR login, we take that token from AZ and we apply it to your Docker client as well. So Docker is using that client, that token, to talk to ACR.
Perfect.
So that's almost done. It'll push it up there. And if we come over here to our registry, we can now see our image and we see our tag.
Yep.
Now, like anything kind of in the closet, we've got this, it's sitting there at rest. We want it hydrated. We don't want just dry food. We want to cook it. So I'm going to say deploy to app service.
Okay.
So I can just right click here and I'll give it a site name. And we'll call this West US. So that's the name of the app service Linux that we'll create. And because I want it in West US, I'll choose a West US plan. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking my images that are in ACR, and I want to deploy it somewhere. And I'm just using App Service Linux. Of course, this works with Kubernetes and all of our other deployment options as well. It could be a VM or ACI. But I want to do a quick test of this. And what's nice around App Service Linux is it has this webhook notification in it as well.
Right, so you're spinning up app service, and because we announced recently you can run Linux. And when you run it as Linux, it actually has all the Docker capabilities that you need. And what you've done here is just said, go ahead and take that image I just pushed, and let's go ahead and spin it up so I can actually see the image running.
So that's going to start getting set up over there because it's provisioning that resource, and that's going off and doing that. But let me go back, and while it's setting up that first deployment, I wanted to set up a second one, right? I want to have it in both West US, and we'll just pick South Central for the point of this demo. So I want to replicate the registry across two regions. And this was the SKU thing. You'll notice at the top it says, hey, by the way, geo-replication is a feature of Premium. No problem. Because it's managed, I simply go to the Overview tab, and I just tell it Premium, and switching SKUs is as simple as that.
Okay.
So now my replications is enabled.
Got it.
And now you can see these are all the locations that we can geo-replicate to.
Got it. And that's not all of the stamps of Azure, right? Because we have over 40 regions. So this isn't all of them. This is what we have available today.
We're trying to keep up.
Okay.
To be fair. Like,
awesome.
As soon as those new regions, we're actively working to deploy those too. So you'll see, like, this one here in South Africa, those are still coming online.
Yes, exactly. They're building them. One in Johannesburg in Cape Town,
So we'll just tell it to geo-replicate to South Central as well. And again, the beauty of what we're doing with ACR here is there's no additional resources that you are provisioning. You're just giving us the intent of what you want. The implementation we're going to manage for you.
Okay.
So that's off doing that.
And I don't have to push it again to get it to go to the replicated area. You guys are going to take care of that for
me.
All right, perfect.
So let's see. This was the one we just provisioned. If we come over here, you'll see.
Browse to it, right?
Yes, exactly what we're going to do. So we'll just launch this up, and it's the first time it's spinning up, so it has to do.
It's going to JIT the app and everything, for sure.
No, we don't JIT apps anymore. Those are built in the container, right?
That's a very good point. Absolutely, that's a very good point.
We want an image to be as optimized as possible.
Awesome.
So I kind of had some fun here with it was the hello world kind of thing.
It's like,
we're going to say hello from. So this one happens to be hosted from West US. Now, since we've geo-replicated this, and I'm in two regions now, we'll see that it's now syncing. But while it's syncing, I can still configure this. And see, it's actually done there. I'll come over to Hello World. I'm going to say deploy to app service again. And
I see. You're not going to have to tell it which of the registries to grab from. You're just going to put it in a region, and it's going to figure out which registry to pull from based on the region that you're running it in. Got it. All right, perfect.
So I'll just say South Central. And The beauty of this is we're just basing it on that single URL. We let Traffic Manager handle routing. So if I wanted to, you know, if I deployed to another region and I didn't put registry there yet, if I added it later on, it's just going to know to route it later on, right?
For any feature pulls that it has to do.
Exactly.
Got it.
Okay, so that's deploying. We come over here and we'll see that second one will come up here in a second.
While that's running, is this available for everyone right now? What state is this in?
Yeah, so the managed registries for basic, standard, and premium are GA'd.
Okay.
The geo-replication feature is in preview.
Okay.
One of the things that we learned is that people use registries where they want to. So the only way for us to properly preview something is to literally be in every region. So that is one thing, is you'll notice that ACR, even our preview features, will be available in all regions.
Okay, great.
So now I'll go to the South Central one, and we'll see that load up in a second here. So you can see here's, we're in West US, and as soon as this one finishes coming up, we'll see, right?
Yep.
So
very,
there are those
cool.
Two.
Awesome.
Now, you know, great, could have done anything there. Let's go make a quick change here. And heading one, hello from Azure Fridays with the D-man. Dumb man?
That's fine.
With spelling and everything.
We all know it's the black shirt, but we'll be all right.
Okay, so we'll just rebuild that. And I'm building it, you know, here locally. Of course, we can do this with our build systems, but
sure.
I'm just kind of showing the basic scenarios. So it's grab that. It's going to just pull that content in. And this is using our multi-stage builds, by the way.
Okay.
So it's really nice that everything's encapsulated as one now. And let's see, that I have to retag it. So we'll retag it. And then I'm going to push it again. And you'll notice it only had to push that one delta layer.
Yep.
And if I come over to here, what we'll see if I go to the webhooks, what you'll notice is we've actually configured two webhooks. Their webhooks are now regional.
Okay.
So I have a webhook for West US. And if we look there, that one's triggered. Let's see if this one, it's already triggered. So it's already been synced across the two. And if I refresh this page, we can see that our change was put there. And if we refresh this page, we can see that our change was there.
To both.
So if I can get my tabs correct, one set of content that I'm building deployed, or one image, I should say, one code base. And then the content that I'm pulling in, whether it be Spanish or French or different pricing, or in this case, a different map, it just pulls from that local registry.
Fantastic.
So that's kind of what I wanted to show off today.
Well, thank you so much. We're learning all about Azure Container Registry here on Azure Friday.